Welcome to Cornwall. Welcome to Curnow EXP. We're solely based in Cornwall and we explore from land, sea and air. We're about to go on a journey, so let's get ready to explore Cornwall. The things that you might see on our channel are paranormal investigations, urbex, drone flying, boat adventures, mine exploring, and everything in between. Let's go now, folks, and explore. Hello, folks. Yes, you've guessed it. We've returned. So, I believe that this is the original entrance gate into Triamble Mine. Very well built concrete post, as you can see, and there's one that mirrors over here as well. Now, I know for a fact we're on the money today, folks. What I mean is, this is the original entrance for lorries and truck and anything that was brought non-railway to this mine. Now, I'd just like to thank Dave, who is one of our subscribers, for giving me some historical facts about this mine, which I find fascinating, folks. Absolutely fascinating. Now, this was a very wealthy mine when it was working in its heyday, and to have its own standard gauge railway track is completely unheard of. Now, obviously the other day we did do a walk around, and we've been around over there. Now, according to my records, where the holiday camp is, where you can just see the foundations just over there, that's been a bit of land that's been filled in over when the mine closed, because it would have been right in behind where all the bushes are and that as well. So today we're not seeing all of it, if you know what I mean, folks. What I mean is a lot of this mine has been obliterated, erased from history, which is such a shame. But down here we know for a fact that there is some bits and pieces left that we are going to have a look at today. I do have the drone. I will be using the drone at some point or some stage just to get some aerial shots and perspective of the quarry, which is can be seen today. And I do believe that just down below us here now, there is a potential generating building that was associated with the mine, folks. Now, that will probably be the first thing we look at. Now, another thing which I was aware of it, but I didn't really say about it last time, and that is there was an internal narrow gauge railway line here, and it had quite an extensive amount of track down here, and they had trouble with their engine, so they purchased another engine from another mine, which is from the area that we're from, folks. Now, they purchased the old Dolcove narrow gauge steam locomotive, and when they actually brought it to this location, they used another traction engine, which I do know the owners of them today, and that is the engine known as the Cornish Maid. And that traction engine was utilized by this mine for a short time. Now, yeah, isn't that amazing? Absolutely amazing, folks. The history, when you start scratching the surface, it's just unbelievable the amount of stuff that you can find out. Now, I don't know if what we're going to see today, because I have been down here, but I wasn't really in the right frame of mind back then. What I mean is, I wasn't really looking for anything to do with mining and railways and anything like that back then. It was just basically a discovery that somewhere that we've never been before. Anyway, I hope you're all good. Please like and comment and share. And if anyone wants to buy me a coffee, feel free, because every penny we get goes towards the channel, folks. Now, let's go and find this history, shall we? So we're using wide-angled lens today on the Pocket 3. It's an extra lens that the Creator Combo comes with. Now, this has clearly been dug out here. It's got an embankment here. And so we're looking for anything that's going to be associated with this mine, folks. You can see the embankment on the side there. I think that there follows around. The quarry is around to the left. So we've got some kind of construction here. It looks like a toilet, a little toilet there, look. Straight away, folks, archaeology, right away. Industrial archaeology. Shit, there's another building there, look. Wow. There we go. So what is this? This obviously dates from the mine. And it does look like that would have had a narrow gauge track on it, because that looks, well, to the untrained eye, that looks like World War II brick, but I think that's for a railway, folks. Now, there's another one here, and there's an embankment above that as well. So, oh crikey, look, there's more buildings over there. Holy crap. I just walked over a little bridge there. Wow, look at this. Holy mosey, I didn't even know that was there. Look at this, folks, look, it's like a loading bay. Holy. We're gonna have a close-up look at this if we can. So this looks like, this is something to do with the Great Western Railway. It looks like a loading bay or a loading platform to the untrained eye. Yeah, very much looks like that. Now, how far can we go with this? There's lots of detritus here. So somebody's been dumping wood and that here. Don't really know how far we can go with that, because it looks quite impenetrable. So I do believe we're actually standing on the old track bed. Look, see the wall down here? And there's another building, something right there. It looks like a chimney. The grain looks a bit precarious there, so I think we'll call that one for now. But, oh God, getting tangled up already, folks. Oh, flipping it. Right, so clearly a loading bay of some description. Now, like I said, there was an internal narrow gauge track here, so that was utilised for moving bits and pieces around. So, and I think that's what that is connected to there. Now, there is a bit of a path down here, so we'll just have a little look down there a minute. So we've not really looked at any of the other parts that are here. So apparently there is quite a bit here, folks. Now, I don't know at this moment in time, but I found some metal things. Something metal down here. Ah, look, it's the end of the loading. Look at this. So what have we got here then? Corrugated iron sheeting. Holy crap, look at, holy moly, look at this, holy shit. Right, good job I got my torch with me. You would never have known this was here. Blinking heck. Right, folks, I had a premonition about that I should have brung a torch, and I have, so it's all good. Look at this. So obviously the track would have went in underneath here, and this is where they would have loaded the wagons through the holes in the roof there. Can you see? I didn't expect this today. You can still see where the sleepers were, look. Look, if you look down here, look. See these like lines here? That's actually where the sleepers were, folks. Hey? You can't make it up, can you? I didn't expect to find this. Wowzers. So somebody's tried undermining there. I don't know why. But this what we got here is probably some of the ore that they were digging out. Hang on, what's this over here? Look, we've got a bit of original iron, folks. That's probably, I was going to say it's a fish plate, but it's not a fish plate for holding tracking. But look at this. You just can't make it up, can you? I didn't even know this was here. Flipping heck. This is just madness, folks. Wow, it's definitely paying off. This is going to be one awesome video, this is. I had no idea this was here. Right. I've got a tree growing out there, so he's been there a day or two, hasn't he? Right, turn the light off. We don't need the light for a minute. Vintage car bumper, folks. Probably an old Ford, maybe? Who knows? Right, so we've got this wall here, which I'm assuming, could it be the same again? Possibility cannot be ruled out. Let's have a look. Oh, bloody bugger. Oh, I'm all caught up. Sorry about the cramp, camera work. I'm just caught in a bush. Right, okay, so. Ow! I hurt myself. Right, okay. Let's have a look up here a minute, see if we can find anything or no. Oh, God, I caught again. Flipping heck. Right. So we're actually on the loading bay now, on top of, so I'm assuming that was standard gauge railway track down there, and this is the narrow gauge bit up here. That's what I'm guessing. I'm just going to put the torch away a moment. Right, I don't think there's no need to hang about on this bit now, because I don't think there's anything here. Now, we will get the drone up in a bit, but that ain't going to be just like that. So we got to get back down there again now. All right. Got to get through this tangle of bushes here, folks. Flipping heck. Right. Can we do it without getting caught? Ow, 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 you bugger. Right, I'm through. Okay. Oh, right. I think we managed to get through that one all right. Just. So, oh look, we've got a sluice gate there, folks. Can you see it? So they would have used the water for something. I don't know what. Grinding or something like that. But that was a bit of a find, wasn't it? Look at that. So clearly the track went in there. Okay, right. Oh. So we've got to a conclusion now that there's a couple of sidings here, and this is where the wagons would have been loaded. Probably a 5-plank wagon, standard Great Western Railway design. And I've no doubt, folks, that if all that there detritus wasn't there, this would have went on a lot further. But there probably is more loading bays like that, I should imagine. So this foundation here, even though it does look like it could take standard gauge, I got a feeling that this is for narrow gauge, folks. That's what I think. I don't know. This is what I'm just surmising. That's all I'm doing. I'm just surmising. Until we look at some archive, we're not going to know. So it does look to me that obviously this one here is lower than that one. So yeah, that does look like that to me. Now, whether I'm right or wrong, I don't know. Now, we've got this building here. Not really sure what to make of this one. Don't know if it's abandoned or what. I've got no idea. I don't think that is abandoned, to be honest. So we won't have too much of a nosy on that one because I don't want to disturb anybody. Right. Now what we're doing is we're heading down to the quarry, folks. There's a massive quarry down here, and it's one of the main parts of Triamble Mine. Now, I don't know what else we can see right now, but whatever we find is going to be interesting. So this looks like an original bridge here, and there is a pathway leading down there. So I think we'll just have a look here a moment, because I think this is where the quarry is or was or is. So let's just venture down here a moment and see what we can see. We're gonna have to get down quite low here. Oh God. It's a bit awkward, folks. I'm glad I got my wellies on anyway. Right, so this is the quarry right here. It's a bit boggy here, so I'm really pleased that we put our wellies on. So the narrow gauge track would have came down through here, without a doubt. And just taking my time, because the path does look quite boggy in places here. This is what put me off last time, I think. The path, because I didn't have wellies on. This is probably over 10 years ago, or more than that, probably. So yeah, I do think we're following a narrow gauge track here. So we've just skirted by the quarry there by the looks of it. Don't really know how far we can go with this path, but we'll just keep it rolling for now. So it does look like people do get down here. Another entrance way up there, possibly. You can just imagine a little steamer coming down through here. This is definitely a track pathway here, right here, because it's flat, folks, and it's narrow gauge, standard narrow gauge. So we're looking for, right, so the track obviously stops around here. I'm looking for anything that is connected to the mine, folks. At this moment in time, I can't see anything. I am scanning about. I know you guys are staying still, but my eyes are all over the place at the minute. Wonder if we can see the remains of the standard gauge track bed as well. We should be able to. So I've got to be careful where I'm watching, looking, because I don't want to trip up and fall in the river, really. Might be funny, but don't want to do that. Right, so in a moment, we will go back on that other trackway and see what else we can find there as well. So I am waffling a bit. I know some of you enjoy that, so all good, I guess. So we will definitely get the drone up, 100%. Probably won't have to go back out to the main entrance for that. But yeah, this This to me does look like a little narrow gauge track here. I'm pretty confident we've walked past the quarry. So let's continue walking down. Now the former Great Western Railway or Cornwall Minerals Railway standard gauge track should be in the valley here somewhere, but at the moment in time I cannot see any evidence of that. Right, I think we might need to backtrack here a bit because this looks like it comes out in a farmer's field. Yeah, so I'm assuming this is a right of way. There is no signs or anything, folks, so you know. Yeah, okay. So I think, getting a bit hot now. I think it's best that we backtrack now. So we'll go back and we'll head over that bridge that we seen a minute ago. Anyway, just looking in the undergrowth, folks, and come across this. Now, it is brick built and it does look quite interesting. At this moment in time, I've got no idea what this is. It's just a room. Right, so to the untrained eye, this looks potentially World War II. Now, obviously, this could be that, but I got a feeling it could be more than that. Right, this looks like a gunpowder store. I think this is a gunpowder store. Adam, if you're watching, this could be a good place for a fry-up, mate. Obviously, I'm not going to pinpoint where this is. Not publicly, anyway, but wow, what a find. I did not expect to find that. See the... Oh, look. Can you see that? Look, it says 1912. Holy crap. Oh, I've got to take some pictures of this. Flipping heck, this was made in 1912. Yeah, it looks like World War II, doesn't it, to the untrained eye? But yeah, this is obviously a gunpowder store, folks. A dynamite store. Further along this, what I think is a narrow gauge track here. And we're not far from the quarry that which we know that is here. And I think when this mine closed, they did do a lot of health and safety crap. What I mean is to stop people from falling down in the quarry and what have you. Because I think what they've done is they've piled up a lot of soil to stop anybody from falling inside the quarry as such. So I'm not really sure that I can actually physically get in there, but I will be able to fly above it anyway, so you will be able to see it from above, folks. Now I think we're right next to where the actual quarry is, and obviously over the years the entrance has disguised itself, if you know what I mean. So we've got to walk around this bit of quagmire here. I think that's the water that's coming out of the quarry. So, yeah, I think that's the quarry dead ahead there. So it doesn't look like I can get in there unless I want up my neck up to be covered in mud and what have you. So yeah, so that's the quarry just there, folks. I know it's there, but it's flooded and we can't get to it really. So we will send the drone above and we will get an aerial perspective of that. we've already found a dynamite store, which was really cool, dated 1912. I have filmed it and taken pictures as well, which I think is bloody awesome. Now, this bridge is an original one, folks. It dates from when the mine was working, and it's quite substantial. And I do think we're now going to encounter the Great Western Railway, folks. So I'm pretty confident that we will walk right over the old track bed, which at the moment I can't see it. Now, look. Oh no, it's a tree. I thought that was a bit of old railway track there for a moment, but it's not. Right, so I'm confident now that we've just walked over the track bed, and I've got no idea where this lane goes, so we're going to follow it for a bit and see where we end up to. Getting a bit warm now again. So I'm really pleased that I've looked into the bushes, and we've already found something that's made it worthwhile, folks, which is the dynamite store, dated 1912. That was just absolutely amazing. It's made it worthwhile. So I do believe that we're heading away right now, so we might be coming to the end of the land explore, but don't worry, there's still a drone flight to come. Right, so we're right by someone's property here, clearly see that. We've got a fence there, so I've got a feeling that's something to do with the holiday camp. It does look like it, yeah. Right. Getting a bit bushed now, so we'll have a little bit more of a nosy up here, and then we'll have to call it a day. So continuing walking up this path, clearly a public right of way. Yeah, I think this might be the end of our land-based explore today. I know where I am now, so we are actually walking away from the mine. Whew. So this is Triamble Farm, folks, or barn, which we walked by here the other day. So look at that old building, folks. Don't it speak volumes? Right, well, I think that might be the end of our video today, so I really do hope you enjoyed it. I think there is more things here to find, but I've really chosen the wrong time of year to do it, because the ground is so boggy and wet, it's just madness. So there will be a drone flight. I'm not sure how long we will fly the drone for, but I will get a minimum of 5 minutes and see what else we can find. What I'll probably do is hover above the quarry and then follow some of the track bed back if I can, which would be quite interesting, won't it? Anyway, hope you enjoyed this bit so far. Here comes the drone video. See you later, folks. Cheers and God. Oh. we are pretty much done here now. So we're now going to leave sight. And to those eagle-eyed people, we have cut down on putting our stickers about, but I am going to put one here somewhere. And hide it away. So we're now going to walk over where the track bed was, and I do believe that it's somewhere along here. It's a loading bay just over there, so probably it was right here. Probably. Ah, look. There we go. Part of railway infrastructure, folks, still there. I believe that's ball rail. Could be wrong on that one, but I doubt it. There we go. Well, that was really interesting. I hope you enjoyed this one. Please like, comment and subscribe. Share us out. And anybody wants to buy me a coffee, there will be a link in the description. Not e-begging or anything, folks, but it does really help. So yeah, what a great location. Hope you enjoyed that one. We might venture back here with some crew members or Adam from TWEX at some point in the future. But what a location. What a location. I think, to be honest, if I were to dig a bit deeper there, I probably could find more stuff, but it's the case of, do I want to get myself covered in it? Probably not. We might come back and do a ghost hunt here one night, see what some members of the crew say. But all in all, a very interesting location. I do believe the mine here was a lot bigger than what you've seen today, but the holiday camp there, basically all the holiday camp ground is all being landfilled in there, so it's not the original structure. I do believe the mine itself is further back. I don't think you can gain access to that unless you are a real die-hard explorer. So we are kind of die-hard folks, but I'm not really into abseiling and stuff like that anymore. We will do like easy things, but you know, hard stuff is just not for us anymore now. So I'm at the end of our video, so I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later in the week. From me at Trehamble Mine, I bid you farewell. See you later, folks. Cheers and God.